What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull this trigger. Out of the front here, it's gonna send a high intensity X-ray beam. And then as it bounces off of different elements, it's gonna send back different signals, which is going to help me interpret what's in here. Holy moly. There's boron, magnesium, and actually, there's a lot of arsenic in here. These levels of arsenic are really, really high. We're looking at 2,000 times higher than would be acceptable to drink.
Humans have been mining the crystalline metalloid known as arsenic since the days of ancient Greece. The element is used to produce a wide assortment of items, from medicines and wood furniture to electronics and chemical weapons. But because it's often odorless and tasteless in compound form, arsenic has also been known as the perfect poison throughout history. Iconic villains like the Roman Emperor Nero and the Borgias used it to eliminate their foes.
If ingested, the toxin can pose serious hazards, including cancer, nerve damage, and death.
And it turns out that Mono Lake has one of the highest concentrations of arsenic on the planet. So it probably isn't the ideal beach destination. Unless you're one of these invincible microbes.
You can see those dark rocks? We're going over there.
Perhaps no one knows this so-called alien bacteria better than geomicrobiologist Ron Ormland. He worked with the NASA-supported team of researchers that discovered it back in 2010. Today, he's taking me to an island on the lake for a close encounter.
Holy smokes, look at this one. This one is bright red. You don't usually see this when you're walking around through the forest.
Nope.
When it was first found, the microbe, dubbed GFAJ1, appeared to resemble no other organism on Earth. It seemed to redefine our understanding of the building blocks of life. Early tests indicated its DNA substituted arsenic for phosphorus, one of the six elements every other living entity requires. It was thriving on a substance that kills virtually everything else.
All these microorganisms right here, they get energy from the arsenic. They're photosynthetic, they're like plants, except they are bacteria, they're more primitive.
So essentially, we're looking at a group of organisms that have a completely different pathway of getting energy than anything else that's on the planet with as far as plants go.
Yes, and this is just the perfect environment for them. And they're red because of the pigments they use to harvest the light.
This ability to adapt to such intolerable conditions classifies these bacteria as extremophiles. Extremophiles can thrive in the most forbidding of environments, places that are intensely hot, cold, acidic, and even radioactive. Their remarkable ability to live in such extreme conditions has made them instrumental in developing revolutionary medications and industrial products. It's also why they're considered invaluable in the search for extraterrestrial life, because they shed light on how living creatures could withstand the harsher conditions that prevail on other planets. Most scientists now believe the mysterious microbe of Mono Lake is simply an earthly extremophile. But the bacteria's staggering tolerance for arsenic is unique, even among that adaptable group.
So is it possible there's a more otherworldly explanation?
That prospect would seem much more plausible if we had other proof that life does exist beyond Earth. So far, we don't. But some astronomers think we could be close to finding it right here in our own solar system. In 2016, NASA made an astonishing find on Enceladus, Saturn's sixth largest moon. An unmanned probe revealed strong evidence of hot hydrothermal activity in an underground ocean located near the moon's south pole. With vent-heated, chemical-rich waters, Enceladus could closely resemble the environment in which life first originated on Earth. In other words, the place could be teeming with alien microbes. So astronomers are now planning another mission, aimed at hunting them down. While NASA continues to probe for signs of alien life in outer space, I'm searching for it right here in California. before I take any theory off the table, I need to take a step back and figure out how exactly this lake got so toxic in the first place. I'm hoping if I can trace the arsenic to its source, I'll uncover clues about the origin of the bizarre bacteria that's feeding off of it.
What did you bring?
I got some magnetometers.
So I'm bringing in geophysicist Jared Peacock to help me conduct a magnetotelluric survey of Mono Lake that will tell us more about what's going on deep beneath it.
So with magnetotellurics, or MT as we call it, we measure the Earth's electrical resistivity.
Walking around its shores, I've noticed several springs bubbling up from beneath the surface. Springs like this usually originate deep in Earth's substrate. And they could offer the lake's toxic chemicals, and maybe these bacteria themselves, a ride up from the bowels of Earth. An MT survey uses electrical and magnetic fields to identify variations beneath the Earth's surface. With the data, it then constructs a 3D map of the different geological layers.
So we're measuring the Earth's electrical response to that magnetic field, and that gives us electrical resistivity.
Housed inside each pipe are two sets of copper wires that are used to measure magnetic fields traveling towards the ground.
So these are called induction coils. Basically what they are is just a bunch of copper wire wrapped around. And through inductions, when that magnetic field comes down, it generates a current in that coil, and that measures the magnetic field. Right. So we have the magnetic field coming down. That's what these guys are measuring.
A set of sensors then analyze the electrical fields that bounce back towards the surface.
So we have to bury these.
Put this one right here.
This is technology that can plot out areas as deep as tens of thousands of feet. So it's especially useful for petroleum and mining exploration. But today, I'm hoping it will uncover the secrets of one of the planet's most extreme life forms.
So now we flip the switch.
Yeah. Let's have a look.
All right.
By plugging the survey data into an algorithm, we can then create the 3D model of the lake bed's geological structure and scan for clues about the source of its lethally toxic elements. But there's also a big clue right before our eyes. Mono Lake is surrounded by volcanic terrain, and volcanoes are a major source of the lifeblood of these bacteria, arsenic. So as the survey data starts coming, Jared explains how we're looking for signs of underground magma chambers, which are the heart of volcanoes.
So magma is very hot, it's warm, it's liquid, so if we have a magma chamber, it'll come right up as a nice bright spot.
This is the moment of truth right here.
So.
Holy moly.
So if we go
that's
through
pretty
this.
Pretty detailed.
So here's the magma chamber that's underneath the Mono craters.
Okay, so that's?
It's about 10 kilometers deep.
Oh my goodness.
And this is what's coming out underneath the lake. So what's Whoa. Right below us.
Wow, so a massive amount of magma is flowing 6 miles under our feet. Using the results, Jared traces the source of the magma back to a 10-mile volcanic chain just south of the lake, known, ironically, as the Mono Craters. But these craters are the work of planet Earth, not alien invaders. They are actually volcanoes that last erupted only 600 years ago, and they're still considered active. So they are still spewing arsenic-rich gases through a set of vents which lie directly beneath the lake. So now we know how it became the perfect home for these strangely toxic microbes.
But the question remains, did those bacteria originate here and evolve to withstand increasingly poisonous waters?
Or did they hitch a ride from outer space and arrive already well-suited for an arsenic-rich environment?